personal, your heart's personal. Now my heart sits full. Whatever it is that I have done, that it is what you have done, he cannot even remember. Welcome everybody tonight. Prophet John Haggai here. We welcome you to Bible study. Like you to open up your mouth and begin to talk to God. Begin to talk to God. Begin to talk to God. Thank you, Father. Blessed be thy holy name. Open up your mouth if you can and begin to talk to God. Worship him. Worship him tonight in the name of Jesus. They were all together like tonight in one place in the upper room, praying for God's power from on high. Jesus said that he will send his power not so long ago, and that he'll set their soul on fire. Suddenly come the sound of a mighty rushing wind. The soldiers set aflame. To them gave he the power when they call upon his name. Suddenly can feel his mighty power. Suddenly feel the voice of him. And I know that I will never be the same again. You can find tonight what you need on the altar. Leave behind all the weight that presses in, for the Spirit of the Lord is still moving. Suddenly, get ready for the hand of God. Glory to God. Never let your heart become troubled, no need to be afraid. Hallelujah. When it seems you don't have the strength to carry on, there is glory in God's presence, his power in his word. He's our anchor and our peace in every storm, yeah. So my friend, call on the Lord and trust his name. He's the same, still the same. For he's our God and he's us, and he's a God that loves us, praise his name. Suddenly, I can feel his mighty power. the same again. You can find tonight what it is that you need on the altar. Leave behind all the way that stresses him, for the Spirit of the Lord is still moving. The Spirit of the Lord is still moving. Even tonight, oh God, oh God. Spirit of the Lord is still moving. Suddenly, hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Praise the Lord, everybody. Welcome to this service this evening. We are getting ready. I'd like you to worship God. Take your time. Just worship Him in your own way if you can. In the name of Jesus, the hand of God is getting ready to be revealed tonight. No other God can be called a Father. No other God can be called a friend. No other God can be called Redeemer. No other God is coming back again.
Worship Him tonight, for you came, for you came.
Thank you, Father. We bless your name tonight. Come to bless your name. Yes. Welcome, everybody, tonight. We've come to bless your name. Thank you for who you are. Open up your mouth and just begin to talk to God. Father, we bless your name tonight. Yes, yes, yes. Be it unto you. We love your name. We love your name. We love your name. We love your name tonight. We love your name tonight. We bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name. Thank you, Father. We bless your name. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory. Open up your mouth in your own way. Open up your mouth in your own way. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We bless your name, Father. We offer up our lives as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable before you. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father. We give you glory. Father, in the name of the Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus tonight do as good as unto Zion. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I want us to take a prayer before we proceed on tonight. The book of Psalm. The book of Psalm is going to guide us for prayer tonight. I know it's Bible study, but that's how we conduct Bible study in this side of heaven. Psalm 127 is a scripture you know. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord build a marriage. Except the Lord build a student. Except the Lord build a ministry. Except the Lord build a nation. Except the Lord builds a family. Except the Lord builds a business. They labor in vain that build anything whatsoever it is. I'll repeat that again for clarity. Except that the Lord will build any house. Except that the Lord will build a ministry. Except that the Lord will build a family. Except that the Lord will build a nation. Whoever it is, whatever it is that they will build on, it don't matter what it is. It might be Dubai, it might be Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, it might be whatever it is that they have built in the nations of the world. According to the timeline of God, whatever it is that they have built, it has been built in vain. Now when it means that, it does not only mean physical structures. Singapore, Dubai, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, the United States, and the best of them all have built skyscrapers everywhere when you fly in and out of countries and in cities. That superstructure, when a little bit of an earthquake happens, a tremor happens, whatever it is that man has built can be brought down by another man. Can be brought down by a natural disaster. Can be brought down by just the finger of God touching on the earth. He said it is important for someone out there tonight as you pray that whatever it is that you're building be built in the foundation that is called the author and the finisher of your faith. I want you to open up your mouth and tell the Lord, build my life. Build my life. Build my ministry. Build what it is that you're building. Open up your mouth and tell the Lord. It is in vain to wake up early, he said. To rise up early in the far home, in the rat race, in plus one, or whatever call that your country represents. It is in vain for men to labor. Wake up, rise up early, like a bird that has been released out of the snare of the fowler, and come back in the evening, eating the bread of sorrow. I have seen a wonder. I've seen something, a disorder happening in the franchise of men. Men waking up early, and coming back with the bread of sorrow. The preacher declared that he has seen a wonder and a disorder and a marvel under the sun. That there are men that can also put up a hand into labor, and it is in vain that they will come back having done all in the marketplace, and then princes walk in barefoot, and then the slave riding on horses. He said the race is not for the swift, the battle is not for the strong. Say time and chance happens to them all. Open up your mouth. There is time and chance. We all have 24/7. We all have 24/7 days in a week. We all have 24 hours. There is nobody that has 27 hours. Nobody has an advantage. You create your own advantage. According to my apostle, you create your own advantage. He said it is in vain to wake up early. The curse of waking up early is not in the rising. It is in the coming back with no bread whatsoever except the bread of sorrow. And to need that bread thereof. For so he gives his beloved sleep. You're going to open up your mouth. I know it's Bible study, but as you know already, it's crazy out here in the spirit. We're going to fly as to where the spirit is living. Open up your mouth and tell the Lord. Is someone praying out there? Is someone praying out there? Is someone praying out there? Makosika baski bidi anakamando. Lere de koski pratalia. Le kabrantolia kama konta de kebregade. Shade de kontolia kama kas kebregade. Kadadadadabawosh kadadabande. Liri di kas kobrotolia kaimene de munda. Bandos kebregade de dia kaita le kebregadosa. Kidiri di kantole kebregades kapratalia. Open up your mouth and tell the Lord. Asuma na kante liya mana. Except the Lord builds anything. It don't matter what school you went to. It don't matter where it is that you're connected to. It don't matter what nation you live in. He might have the best of policy, the best of the bullion, the best of Federal Reserve, the best of a central bank. But a natural disaster like the one that happened in Japan, like the one that happened in Haiti, like the one that came in Mexico, like the one that came again in Japan, and the tsunami that wiped out everything, that men were forced to bow down and begin to call on a God maybe they did not know. Except the Lord will build something. They that build it, build it in vain. It don't matter how pretty you are. It don't matter what it is that you're connected to. It can be shaken in a twinkle of an eye. Ela manana mosha. Cry out to the God of heaven. Tell the Lord, I will build according to the pattern. I will build this house, this marriage, this business, this my work, the work of my hands. I will build according to the pattern that has been shown me in the mountain of revelation. Not by might, not by power. Zerubbabel, this city will not be established. The foundation of this city will not be established because men know how to be. No. Because men know how to choose choice times. No. He's saying it is by grace. Grace will lead you home. Grace will lead you out. It's a pattern that has been shown in the mountain. Open up your mouth and cry out to God. Tell him, I will not rise up early, 4 a.m., 3 a.m., go into the marketplace, come back with the bread of souls. I will not wake up in the morning, cry out to the God of Zion, and have the rod of the wicked afflict my work, afflict the evidence and the results of my priesthood. I decree and declare, the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon my allotment. As a righteous man and as a righteous woman, I will not stretch my hands in iniquity. I will not stretch my hands in iniquity. I will not doubt the faith that I have in God. I will not doubt my God at any single moment. As a young man, as a young woman, cry out to the God of heaven tonight. Tell the Lord, except you build me, except you build this business, except I be an entrepreneur in the hands of God, except you build this house, except you watch over my babies, even if I put CCTV, even if I put the best of security, they that labor, they that watch, they that can stay up, will watch in vain. Security is in the house of God. Security is in the hands of God. Security is in the hands of God. I am Selebo Hosha. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro. They run to and fro. They run to and fro. Watching over his own people. Akoseke benene kantele. Lidi di kasko pratolia kaide lebo hosha. Lerebe koska brantalia.
Thank you.
business. You can't craft a strategy long enough to be able to craft a strategy long enough to cement your business against the vagaries, of COVID-19. Except the Lord kept the business. Except the Lord kept the children. Except the Lord kept you. Lord, insurance enough to keep your son away from sickness. There is a God in heaven. There is a God in heaven. There is a God in heaven. Come on, time. Come on, don't play with it. There is a God. There is an anointing there for this prayer. Open up your mouth and tell them, if the Lord will not watch over that relationship, you can't keep it, not with a ring. You can't keep it, not with your faithfulness. You can't keep it, not with your beauty. There is a spirit in God that he can impart on you. An impart on your marriage. An impart on your relationship. An impart on you. That can sustain what it is that he has given unto you. Your life is too short. There are too many variables in life. There must be a God in heaven and can become a sure foundation. Zerubbabel is not by mind. It ain't by power. It's by my spirit, saith the Lord. Worthy of every praise I could ever pray.
Treasures.
foundation. I repeat, he's the sure foundation. He's the real treasure, Andrew. He's the real treasure. We explore God. Yes, like the scientist will explore space. Like an astronaut will explore space. We come to Mount Zion to explore God. He is the sure foundation. Help us, Holy Ghost, tonight. Help us, Holy Ghost, tonight. Holy Spirit, help us tonight. Help thy servant tonight in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Do us good in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. I heard the Lord say the other day that his church will not be touched unless it is someone who paid by his own life for that church. Hear me again. I heard the Lord say, and I can read it to you. I sure hope I wrote it somewhere here. I don't know why is it that I'm sensing the prophetic coming along. It's part of this ministry, is the first call. Lalime ne kazuma na mande le gabrazufre ketele. Sagididibi kalamano sobratalia. Baruze kebratalia kavanana mushamana na manda. Baruze breske bratalia kaipete skumanana. Manginde le geberonda katalia kaipere skupatatale. Spirit of the Lord is here. Evidence is all around. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. Fill our hearts with your love, your love. To tell the church, whoever will touch the body unless he has allowed it, whoever it is that will touch the body, in other words, his body, worldwide, to men and women that have inclined themselves, hear me, is either they touch the body of Christ by their own life, at the price of their own life. We are getting there. Hear me, the lion of the tribe of Judah is getting ready to roar. Oh yes, men have agendas, nations have agendas, kings of the earth, that is what he told me, that the kings of the earth have gathered together according to my word in Psalm 2, but I, from heaven I shall laugh, and that I will give them to their own derision. He said, whoever touches my body shall pay with their own life. They didn't die for it, therefore they cannot touch it. Rejoice, Zion. We are getting to the best of times in this thing that they call the church and the Holy Ghost. We are getting to the best of time in the days of the kingdom of God. We are getting to the best of time. I feel that my help coming. We are getting to the best of time in the Spirit of God. The best of time in the kingdom. We are living in the kingdom age. Whoever it is that has looked down on the church, looked down on the remnant, looked down with all its weakness, with all with its inadequacies, with all of this and that, there is a remnant. There are men and women that have bought, paid the price unto God, paid the price in their own life, laid their life down for the sake of seeing the kingdom of God. Hear me and hear me well. Whoever will touch that body, they will not have designed the body as Paul will teach regarding the Holy Communion. They will pay with their own life. Hear me? the kings of the earth pay with their own life. Alasuka brantelia kaini ni ninasola manale. We are getting ready to see an unleashing of the power of God like never seen before. Never seen before. I better quit now and get into the teaching tonight. Otherwise, we're going to get into something here that is getting hard to finish. We began on the series, Favour, the mystery of favour, that's the series we began, and we began to understand by books, and we're getting ready to begin to see Exodus 3 and 21 was our main scripture, and Esther chapter 2 and 15, and I will give these people favour in the sight of the Egyptian. It shall come to pass that when ye go, ye shall not go empty. And we dealt with the mystery of emptiness, or the pain of an empty hand. The pain of the empty hand, we understood by books that faith is tied to the work of your hands, and that the absence of favor will result in hardship. We understood by books, Psalm 19 verse 17, that the scripture declared that you can pray this prayer that let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us, be upon me, and establish thou the work of my hands. And the Lord, as I've read to you, Psalm 127, unless the Lord watches and builds the house, even he that is building, thinking they're doing something regarding a cement and tiles and paperwork and have acquired, no, he said, even they that build are building in vain. So the favor of God needs to accompany the work of someone's hand. We understood by books that it is favor that makes the difference, of the blessing that creates the covering daily on your work, on your thing, on the thing that will bring result, is the mark of difference that has been put between you that is selling and the other one that is also a seller, the one that is teaching and the other one that is a teacher, the one that is pretty and the one that is also pretty. It is favor that is gained and put on like a mantle on someone that will put a difference. Esther obtained favor in the sight of all of them that looked upon him. And we understood by books that favor worked with sight. It is he that looks over unto you. It is he that watches over Israel that cannot sleep or slumber. He watches, and it is he that looks over you, the one that will like you by sight, that has to be galvanized to begin to put resources into your hands and to begin to look over and watch over. You know, you can be employed and your boss becomes very, very, very demonic, and they somehow are looking for every opportunity, every nook and cranny to begin to fire you. But if you go there with a mantle of favor, sir, hear me, you will get there, and that wicked boss that has fired many will not only employ you, you'll become the best employee in that company. Why? Because there is a strategy in the kingdom of God that let the favor of the Lord be upon the work of my hands. He said it is he that blesses the righteous man. And then he says he will surround you with his favor as with a shield. Psalm 5 and 12, he understood that favor is something that can be won, is something that can be held as a mystery and as a shield. All that and more. For those of you who did not watch over that subject and over that series, you can head over to YouTube. www.johnhaggai.com is the ministry, is the website, and John Haggai Ministries is the website, is the name rather, for the YouTube channel. You can go there and watch that. Tonight, for a few minutes, I sense a very, very strange anointing coming tonight. It could be that God is about to begin to change someone's life. Like you to pay attention. For all of you, there is a method to this madness. There is a method to this madness. And I like all of you who are following this ministry and are part of this ministry, God has joined us together. I'd like you to put off any distraction and any distractor that appears there in the signs. You can answer them according to the anointing that is in you, but don't be distracted, all right? Yeah, pay attention. We can block them, or we can delete them, or we can just love on them. Yeah, they can come in not saved. They can end up out of the broadcast saved and delivered. So I'd like you to put it together tonight for a few minutes. The wonders of favor. The wonders of favor. The wonders of favor. Exodus 3 and 21 still our subject, but tonight I'm going to pick up from Isaiah 60, where we read initially when we were dealing with arise and shining at the beginning of the month. The wonders of favor. What is it that favor can do that can make men be in awe? What is it that God can do someone's life that can make men marvel? What is that mark of difference? Remember, we're in the mark of the difference, the mark of favor. What is it that God can put on a man that can make them different, stand out? What is it that that God can do with a fellow human being, that can do with a daughter and a son in the kingdom? Rather, there is no difference between a man and a woman in the presence of the Lord. It's just a matter of speaking. What is it that God can do that can make a one to be a sign and a wonder, a marvel to their generation? I present to you the wonders of favor. He said in our key scripture, and I will give these people favor in the sight of the Egyptian, in the sight of the enemy, and it shall come to pass that when ye go, ye shall not go empty. I will give. So favor can be given. Just like any other gift can be given. Just like any other thing can be given by God. Among the tokens of the hand of appreciation, when God begins to mantle someone's life, what it is that he comes with, apart from the fivefold of the gifts of the Spirit and the fruits thereof that are produced out of the character of a man or a woman that has been anchored in God, there are also systems of advantage, tokens that God begins to unleash and to give, that your life will begin to become meaningful, somehow begins to be accelerated. Somehow your life begins to look like it has a taste. You begin to be perfumed, and your life begins to make a taste and a wonder and a sign. You become an ensign to the nations. This is what it says. Isaiah 60, verse 11. So number one, apart from what God can be able to give, not protection only, not the spirit that can be poured out and people being filled with the Holy Ghost, begin to speak in other tongues, begin between the power gifts and ascension gifts, all of them that have been given unto God by God, by the Spirit of God. It is not only that. There are things that faith can produce, and then there are things that favor can produce. And among us, the thing that I'm about to share with you tonight is the wonders of favor. It is that you can carry something, a token. You can carry something tangible within your life. It's not something that can be really touched and quantified in regards to something that your hands can touch. But no, sir. It is something that is on you that produces what it is that is with you. Did you get that? Yes. It's something that can come on you that can produce what it is that is with you. Isaiah 60 and 11. Therefore, thy gates shall be open continually. Thy gates, and I taught this before, and I told you what it is that gates represent. And it says that when gates are open continually, it is as a result of something that has come upon an individual, that their gates are perpetually open. We'll not belabor the point tonight, but I'd like you to know that in the name that is above every other name, may your gates open continually. concern. There are men that come into the kingdom of God, born again, they love the Lord, so they say, or they're genuinely lovers of God, giving their lives unto God. And you could be watching, and you ain't born again, you're playing church, you're sanctimonious, you're religious, you think you've got time, so you don't have to put your life together. In this time, you've got time until you're 40, until you're 50, until you're something. There is no time, you need to put your life together. But there is something about a gate that keeps on opening and shutting. It is called the gate of frustration. It is called the almost there gate. Oh yes, it is almost there syndrome. It is a gate of tests. And then while you are just testing the carpet and the table, it's being taken away from you. It is a curse that comes upon men that can be able to behold that which is good. Behold the husband. Behold the ring. Behold the opportunity. And then suddenly it has just disappeared. I told you, I warned you beforehand. Yeah, don't play with this. I know, I warned you beforehand that something heavy is landing on Wednesday services that is becoming a niche and a permanence in this ministry. Pay attention. He says, thy gates shall open continually. Sir, gates amand is a place of access, place of opportunity. And there are many that I could be talking to tonight by the Spirit of God. I don't know who it is that I was sent to, but I'm sent to someone I know. And I know that there could be someone's gate was open one time in marriage. Suddenly it shut, and they're perpetually single with a child and can't go back to that husband. Don't even know where he is now. Maybe he remarried and forgot you. And could be that I'm speaking to someone. One time, the door of opportunity that was given unto formal employment, formal something that came about your profitability. Your company was open. You began to do well, and suddenly the door was open. And then suddenly it shut after 2 years. Shut after 3 years. The gate was open and then it closed. See, about the things about gates is that gates have a time, especially when it is a gate that lands and concentrates and focuses, and behind the gate that there are bullions, and there is an investment, and there is something of worth. They are timed gates. They know that when they are watching over Jerusalem, the gate has to open at a certain hour. It has to open at a certain point, and the sentries have a focus and have a shift. They know when to open, when to close. And the enemy will always know when it is time. Even the enemy that is a terrorist this season, or in the contemporary world, they know when it is. You've seen this from FBI movies and CIA movies and conspiracy movies about security and everything. They know when it is they want to attack and commandeer a station. They will wait up until sometime when the shift is about getting ready to walk up, when the other one is about to salute, and they do the rounds and the shift. Then the enemy will begin to strike at that minute, at that second, and that minute, at that hour. Could be I'm speaking to someone tonight, and your gates are getting ready to open, and therefore that is why you're passing through what it is that you're going through, what it is that you're going. The pain is too much, because something is about to burst open. Out of our belly shall flow rivers. Out of our belly you shall bathe. You're bathing something. That is why it's an intricate web of, demonic timelines. They keep on watching that bloodline. Keep on watching. Who is it that is making noise in that house? Why is this that there's a fire coming from that young man? It could be that you are about to open a sudden gate from your father's house. Different. That has sat for far too long. It's never been open. You will excuse me. I can just kapatalia kaide de mohoshama anta kapaskinia. I can skupatatalia. So all hell is breaking loose. All around people here. All hell breaking loose everywhere. You know why? Because there's a door and is a gate that has been manned behind the gate. He's a trophy behind the gate. He's a heritage behind the gate. Is something that your daddy could access, mama could access it, uncles could access it, grandparents could access it. And behind it is the one the Bible called true riches. The enemy keeps on sitting on there on the partridge, making you sit on that partridge. Sit on that pain, sit on that mockery, sit on rejection, sit on abuse and trauma, so that you don't no longer open the door, you focus on the days of yore. You know, I believe God for a teaching anointing, and this is something that can be done naturally by education or by studying and everything. But what has come on me since the impartation that come on my life are different graces of different men. Even when I talk, I see them while I'm looking at you. And so that's why I keep on telling you, you have to excuse me. Rather, I need to put myself together. Likamano se brentalia kaitele kemenas koborodoli. He said there are gates that shall be open continually. See, the reason why that marriage door and that marriage gate has not opened is because the sentry, the corral, the cop that is sent up there is an ancient spirit. Call for reinforcement from your father's bloodline, from your mama's bloodline. See the door. Why profitability? You've not turned over into the millions, and yet you have the brain. The power that is sitting in the marketplace has been centered there and anchored on that gate. But tonight, the wonders of favor. He said, one of it is this, that is going to command that your gates be open. Notice the language there, if you're a lawyer or a law student. Thy gate shall be, not maybe, shall be, is anchored on conformity, is anchored on authority, is anchored on authority. Therefore, thy gate shall be open continually. They shall not be shut day and night. They shall not be shut day and night. Notice the language is forceful. The language is anchored on the jealousy of God. It's anchored on the immutable two things. That by that, the law, the prophets, foundation of the Christian faith is anchored by two immutable things, that God is never able to lie. When he says thy gate shall be, it means it shall be. When he says it shall not be shut day and night, it means it shall not be shut day and night. So the wonder of favor number one is that favor will command attention from all and sundry. The number one wonder of favor is that your gate shall open continually, and that he will force it open. He will make sure that he has appointed unto you thy dues, to you a heritage and a splendor out of Zion, and that he says you shall not be shut out neither day or night. And then something interesting, hey, would you pray in the spirit for 2 minutes before I proceed? Pray this. Come on, Baba, don't leave me by myself. Come on, First Lady, everybody, everywhere, cry out to God for 2 minutes. Just scatter some tongues of fire. Yeah. Come on, Lady Mikasku Pratalia. Zenevo Bush Kamante Fahina. Katalia Kaitelemina, Meposki Picatelli, Kamanana Montele Capricate. He said, upon the harp, upon the string instrument, will I make my mysteries or my revelation known. Inanamando Sikipetelia Kaibidia, Agabagadan Telecapricatus Capracatoska Pai. Talikas Cobratolia Kaina Minala, finding in Minase Pretelli, Salika Patatoske, one more minute, Talima, Salia Catalia, Eshe, Kaike, Kaike, Pasoto. This no ordinary psalm, it's no ordinary Bible study. Something is getting into the room tonight. Hey, 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 oh, Shamana Cabrasco Patatale. Mekus kabranteli akaina manasa, samakanteli akai kapasko pratale. Kerele bosha parando selia, faiketes kamante kimiga. Meguse brenteli akai tele kabradosa. Holding on to the halls of the altar. Sidia mandala. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. He says, thy gates shall be open continually. They shall not be shut day and night. You see, the mystery of almost there. The pain of almost getting married. Almost getting engaged. Almost eating at the point, at the table of greatness. Almost getting the deal. Almost signing the contract. Almost getting babies. Almost to deliver. Let me tell you tonight, it is the mystery of a gate that has sent you open while you just approach the gate. Yes, it's an almost there syndrome. But it's a demonic gate that has been manned there. And tonight, by the wonder of favor, by the force of favor, we speak to each and everyone tonight. Isaiah 60 and 11. In the name that is above every other name, that your gates will be open. That your gates will be open. That your gates will be open. That your gates will be open perpetually, continually. In the name that is above every other name, the gates to marriage, the gates to settlement, the gates to holiness, the gates to stability spiritually, the gates to giving birth to children, to your womb, the gate of your womb open, the gates to stability open, the gates to stability open, the gates to opportunity open, by the force of favor, the gate to employment open, by the wonders of favor tonight. He said, it shall not be shut day and night. It will not be shut day and night. Malako sekapretale. The Spirit of the Lord is ministering to me tonight, to people here already. Ay, sigibedo shamanande, kabarasko prakatatale. I don't even know if I'm going to finish any point whatsoever. Please bear with me. Please really bear with me. You're dealing with a prophet. You're dealing with someone who is in the Spirit. Psalm 63 and verse 1. O Lord, thou art my God. Early will I seek thee. Early will I seek thee. My soul longeth after thee. It panteth for the word like a thirsty deer to see thy glory and to see thy power, such as I have seen it. In the sanctuary is when you come to Zion, when you come to the church, when you come to the mountain of God, that you see, you need to come and get home with a wonder and a sign, to come and to see the power of God and a mystery getting unfolded. He said, open now my eyes that I may behold wondrous things out of my law. We didn't come to deep theology. We didn't come to another broadcast and another Facebook and another YouTube and another Instagram. No, sir. Aina Selebelosha, Kerebosha, Catalia, Carmasco, Pratali, Kinda Mazuma, Ania Kaiteleke, Pasco Patatali. It's beyond emotion. Surround this. King, I have had a lot of interruption right now in the Spirit. A lot of it. An manda kasuma na kai kia masele manale. This ain't ordinary. This ain't ordinary prophecy. I mean, a ministry or something. Lago sikabatalia kaimene sola manala. Kiririmusha talia pasketete telika patatos kapai. Someone is getting ready to be a wonder and a sign. A wonder and a sign. Say like there shall not be hope, shall not be shunned. Day and night they will be open. In other words, your life will be accessible. Your gift will be put on demand. Your thy anointing will be on demand. All this rising and falling. All this rising and falling. All this being loved today, tomorrow night. All this 14th February being remembered. And the rest of the years is dried up like at the Sahara Desert. Nothing to show for in love life. Nothing to show for thy commitment. Nothing to show for. He said, thy gate shall be open perpetually, continually so. And then here comes the mystery and the wonder of favor. He says, remember the point, favor commands attention. Favor commands attention. Favor commands attention from all and sundry. When it is on you, it is on you. When it is on you, it is on you. Hear me. He says, part B of that scripture, that now that thy gates have been opened perpetually or continually, and that I have put my anointing and my favor like a garment on some lady, on some man, on some woman. Now that thy gates have been opened, hear this. He says, I'm not going to send an angel. I am sending a spirit out of heaven. I am not sending some cheap people. No, I'm not going to send out of the realm of the spirit so that you can just see it and have a revelation and have a vision and have a dream of what it is that I have sent. No. Mm-mm. I am going by the force of what it is that has opened that gate, whatsoever gate it is that has been shut on you before. Now that I have commanded it to open, I am sending men to bring. Hear me, men to bring. Sir, you've not experienced favor until you function in the dimension where men have been sent. Sir, hear me. I know it is good to be given by someone you know. It's good to be given by someone you know. Yeah, when daddy gives you a car, is your daddy. When mama gives you jewelry, is your mama. When your boyfriend gives you that, he is your boyfriend. When someone else gives you from your family or from your relationship, from your bosses, a glass of wine and some goodies and tells you at the end of the year you've done well. You become the best employer or employee, or your shares are up now and everything. That's ordinary. Nothing really to jump about and shout about. It is almost like it is expected. Because you can quantify that from your results and you working hard throughout the year. Maybe having connection two or three. Sir, but when men begin to pray, it is because there is a God on heaven or up in heaven that has put a gate open and has sent by the ministry of angels by decree, let that gate to employment open, and that will be it. It's by decree. Daniel 4:17, you know I love that scripture. This matter regarding this house, this matter regarding battles awake, this matter regarding joy's life, this matter regarding the first lady, this matter regarding this and that, regarding that and that, regarding him and that, this matter is by the decree of the watchers, by the demand of the Holy One, that this man may know that I rule in the kingdom of men, not just in heaven. That in itself is what I'm teaching you tonight. The days where gates keep on open and closing, open, it is a sign that you need to read. It is that there is a demonic sentry that does not want that gate open. When you have it one time, it's breakthrough. When you have it continually, it's called favor. It's called favor. Men begin to liaise, liars, if you may, liaise, liars. It depends with your friendship. When begin to coalesce, everything around you can't stay 1 month with no employment, can't stay 2 days without no call, can't stay 1 year and 7 years and 3 years without men being agitated to look after you. I tell you this, I tell you that, and tell you, here it is, there is a lot here, buy this, invest in this, how we've been said, take this, come into this, get into the meeting, get aligned. It's the wonder of favor. So what I'm teaching you is deeper than the way I'm explaining. The way he's ministered it to me is not the way I'm explaining. Limited in vocabulary. He said the result of that is that men may know. 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 Number two, not only that men may know, is that men now may bring unto thee. Bring unto thee. So when the gates have been forced open, when God has superintended over the blood lineage from whence you come from, whether that be in Mexico, sir, there is no jurisdiction where God is not in charge. You can go to the Mojave Desert and build you a city there and become successful. You can go to Mojave. You can go to the Sahara. You can go across Mexico. You can go to Nebraska, where there is nothing that is growing there except hot air, and build you a city there and call on God and build an altar there. Why? By the force of favor. He says the reason why men have not been coming is because the gate has not been perpetually, continually open. And this small breakthrough, small employment, contracts and coming and going, this sickness getting healed today, tomorrow back, freedom today, tomorrow back, into a point of regret and an indecision and procrastination. Tomorrow you make a decision, then the next day the energy to follow that decision is gone, and something is eating on that gate of decision making. A demon is sitting up there as an entity. Oh yes. But when the gate gets open, lift up your gates, lift up thy head, O ye gates. Be lifted up, O ye everlasting doors. The King of glory shall come in. Who is it that is the King of glory? The Lord Almighty. Why did he say he's the Lord Almighty? Why did he call himself another name? And he's got many names. No, sir. The reason why he has to deploy the almightiness, the bigness of God, is because the gate is an authority tool. He's sitting up there and he will challenge everything that it is that is God has given you on the other side of that gate. Jesus said it this way: for you to enter to a strong man's house, come on, Jesus. For you to enter there, you've got to bind that strong man, remove him, get him out of the gate. And one of the instruments is favor that has been put on you as of a shield. The going down of every enemy, including Goliath, is God mantled a young man, David, in the backyard of the desert with something that was stronger than the technology of Egypt. Stronger than the height of Goliath. Stronger than the weight of his bow. Stronger than the shield he was carrying. It was hidden in the secret place. It was hidden in the crevices of a man that has had an anointing and had a secret relationship with God. A man after God's own heart. Sir, but men will call, you will command attention after this and after this night. For all and sundry, it is a force that will come on you that will make strange men carry your load. Strange men sponsor your vision. Strange men take care of your children. Strange men build your vision up from the ground.
This is
our time. Therefore thy gates, remember the formula, shall be open continually. They shall not be shut. The demonic force that is responsible for opening that door as if you've got done it a favor and then closing it, while you are in the midst of partaking a meal, how are you going to feel? If all of a sudden you're in a high table, a 7-course meal has been served, and while you're just biting, while you're on it, while you're just about, the table is flipped over, thrown out, glasses and cutleries, all of these spilled over, done, all over fracas and mayhem, shootings and shoutings, and everyone is running for cover. I came all the way from the city of Nairobi to tell men and women out there online that in Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. I came to blow the trumpet out of Zion tonight, that everything that has scattered your joy, scattered your peace, scattered your possibilities, scattered your everything that has been put together for you in this year, that package that was supposed to land on time, that has been scattered off the enemy, I bring to you good news. The favor of the Lord will command not only attention, it will bring about togetherness. It will bring together anything that has been scattered. Favor will attract bone upon bone, help upon help. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Destiny helper upon destiny helper. They will line up. They will line up. Ila koseke pretelia. Erebosha talika praskupata talia. Iketentelia manasko pretoli. Seremo kompantelekina. Saina manduseke pretelia. Some of you here, when you're just about to, sickness appears out of nowhere. Wait for a big event. It's a time-sensitive gate. Getting ready to open. That demonic system knows that the covenant that was cut over your life, maybe by daddy, maybe by mama, maybe by a grandfather who loved the Lord, was that when every woman, when every son will reach 30 years, 31 years, let wealth begin to have, begin to be called, begin to give. Let the nation, the ground begin to give yield. And the enemy is a watcher, is a watcher angel. He's watching. Now, standing that door, sending sentries, demonic entities, and you take a lift and go for that interview with all your fully fledged and cute self, and you put yourself together, and that is the day the door should open. You qualify. Your door should open. And that door gets shut right on your face. Tell you, we're gonna call you back. Not even a regret letter. I came all the way tonight with this anointing, and I decree and declare, by the fire, by the finger of God, let every demonic entity, let every demonic sentry, let every demonic police that is sitting up in the secret place, watching over the gate of your employment, watching over the gate of your possibility, watching over the gate of your marriedhood, watching over the gate of your peace, watching over the gate of your health. Tonight, by the Holy Ghost, we send the fire of the Holy Ghost. Burn every subject. We decree and declare, if I be a man of God like Elijah said, let fire answer upon the Syrian army, upon the Syrian army, upon the Syrian army. Let the captain of 50 be taken away. Let the captain of the 50 be burnt of fire in the name of Jesus. Allah, Iribu, Shaika, Keteka Praskumana Kantalea. Pray if you can. Sainamana Shalike Bretel. Kidia Kantolia Kaitalamasa. Sadini Mihana Kantoli. St. Moses, come up here.
He took him up to Banatu Abana Gilead and he showed him all over. Look at the land, Moses. You brought them this far. But because of something that is in your DNA in the house of Levi, you struck the rock instead of speaking to it. You are a man that was advised inadvisedly. You spoke inadvisedly because of the anger, the zeal that came over you. And because I don't want to put down as a protocol for the rest of the children of Israel, look at the land, but you're not going to have it. You will die here and I will bury you myself. It's the spirit of Pisgah. They came up to Banesh and they were looking over there and the land was springing with honey and milk and everything that was there, but more could not enter. Zakantelia kaima na supratalia kaite samanano mosha kantelia kaina mana likeke kabaga zegedegede reketos kapakai ela samantolia kaina namando liva said in thy anger Simeon slew a man. That the anger could not be pacified, it was too hard, they slew a man. And that lineage, 55 generations apart, when Moses came, 5 generations after Moses came from the tribe of Levi, he could not partake. He went there, tested, and he could not enter. So, man, whatever it is that is standing in your lineage tonight, it gives authority, it yields now to the word of his promise. Yes, I commend you into the word of God tonight and I decree and declare. Let every gate that has refused to open now, hitherto open now, open now. Sitting on your possibility, sitting on your marriage possibility, sitting on your priesthood. Yes, that is interfering with your prayer life, interfering with you, with your spiritual life, interfering with your brother. The peace of God that has been eaten as a result of a gate that keeps on giving you numbing season to numb your pain just a little bit. And then when it gets to others, it comes back. Cyclical affliction. That is a timed gate. I speak to it in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that a gate open by the King of Glory, the strong God that we serve. We invoke the name of God. We deploy him to that gate. Your love surrounds us. Door can, door come. Your will be done. Here as in heaven. And lastly, it says, they will not be closed day and night. In other words, 24 hours of favor deliverables. Tokens. Men, as it were, in a commercial kitchen. Chefs out of a cruise ship. That by the ticket that you've paid according to the favor that God has landed and afforded you, you can sit up in that cruise until you get to your destination. And by demand order, until you get to the next destination of life. Tonight, by the anointing, we speak in the name of Jesus to the ministry of men to give to you. He said that men may bring, not angels, not that men may bring, not spirits, that men may bring, in other words, you have done business in the deeper waters. You've done business in the realm of the spirit. That man will be commanded in their night season, sleeping. A dream will be overshadowed, projected unto them. Your name will continually come. Your favor will continually speak unto them. It will precipitate a call. Precipitate an email. Precipitate a WhatsApp message. Somebody is getting ready to occur and to marvel at the wonder of favor. At the wonder of favor of a Gentile shall come. He's going to ordain a token for good. I speak in the name of Jesus. Let your man appear now. Let your man appear now. Let your helper appear now. Let that call appear now. I prophesy in the name of Jesus. Let that help come. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord. Kinini grantoske pretalia. Kamanana monde le capasco pretalia. Kete de bosha kate ke prekete tele. Kibana na mando lo kopraski pai kai kai kai. Kene ba na mando le gavanta skimano. Masku paraski dia kai. Eke kapasusa. Zena mananoske pretele. That man may bring some. The different thing. When Gentiles and strangers begin to come to feed your flock, build your vision up. It's another thing. Oh yes, it's normal when you build in your house, in your mama's house. It's good, it's a level of favor. But hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me. When men begin to put a demand on you, we have to bless you, ma'am. You've got to have this job. You've got to work for us. When nations begin to call and put a demand on your giftings, that is a higher dose of favor. You begin to command attention. It don't matter where your city lands. It don't matter where your face lands. Go to the east. Go to the eastern block of the continent. Go to West Africa. You can be put right in the headquarters of Boko Haram and command favor in the territory. Right in Jos. Right in Calabar. Right in the desert. Right in Mexico. Right in the backyard of the Bronx. And you will still make it. Why? Because favor has come as a shield. It has been forced on men to apply unto you what it is that they came with. They will beg you to feed your flock water. Oh yes, thy garden. I'll read them to you in another on the next Wednesday service. I'd like you to open up your mouth and begin to pray now. Very heavy anointing. I don't know about you, but it is everywhere. Ila manasku brandilia kaine nemosai. Aika seketekebai. I forbid you from getting into 60, getting into 70 without having the wonder of favor. It's unfortunate that I can only deal with one. There is a compatibility driver that needs to come into your hardware. It is called the driver of favor. That driver is called favor. It's a software that is mixed up into your hardware. That men will look at your hardware, your physique, not knowing that the software that is driving the agenda all over your business, it is a system that is called favor. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, may men look at you and marvel and wonder, because you become an ensign for what it is that a young girl with your petite self, a young woman with your physique, can command the dimension of results that you're commanding. Saina mandeke preskupa. I heard by the right ear in the realm of the spirit that the men and women that have been so much delayed, that you have been looked up to, and now you can no longer give an excuse to that your spouse, to that your family, mama, daddy, and to that your partners in business or in friendship, as to why it is that what you say has delayed, as what you do has not come to materialize. I came with a prophetic word to men and women here that look at me as if God is a liar, as if the word and thy faith has not come to the place of expression for what it is that you believe in. I bring to you glad tidings out of Zion. There shall come, it will come to pass, that in the last days I will not only pour out my spirit upon all flesh, but unto you will he come and save. He will come and defend the integrity of his word upon your life. I am prophesying, and I'm speaking an hour to men and women here that have felt neglected, that have been put in the backyard of the cave of Adullam. Somehow, there's no demand for you. Your spouse is looking down on you. Oh yes, sons and daughters are looking down on you. Maybe sisters, maybe in-laws. He brought to me and he told me to bring unto the people that they shall arise and have mercy upon Zion, and have mercy upon a woman, and have mercy upon a man, and have mercy upon a minister, and have mercy upon a family, and have mercy upon that sick baby, and have mercy upon that sick relationship, and have mercy upon that business that has been on the edge and been on the caricature. You try to put it together, he looks like you've been sinking more in debt, sinking more, trying to validate a point like you're working. I brought out of Zion a token. I brought out of a token. I brought out a token tonight. He is the call, the wonder of favor. He said, I shall have mercy upon someone here tonight. And because the time to favor her, the time to favor her, yay, the set time is come. The set time is come. I proclaim liberty. I proclaim liberty. I proclaim the set time. I proclaim the now word. I proclaim a set now word into your life. Take that anointing now. Take that word. Activate it as you pray. Kiana salimanando. Kabin kataskini minano. Malika skupara skupa katai. K kamasuma. Ela mana sadia kantan. Kididibika skupra talia mana noske. Bekeke kamano. Man shall bring. Hitherto you have not asked, ask and it shall be given. Hitherto you have not knocked, knock and the door shall be opened. Someone is getting ready to receive a package that you have nothing to do with them. You receive a call that you've got nothing to do with them. Receive money in your account that you've got nothing to do with them. All held up dues that are paid, that are accrued to your name by the force of favor. I open that door to all to you, and I pray continually that gate will perpetually be open. That man, it don't matter how deep and how you want to sound deep and how spiritual you want to look and to look humble, it will still take men to give to men. It will still take men to give to men. It's called the ministry of men. Mani saika mana kadarabaru shamanda. Lady, it is men, it is the lack of men. You are lacking a sent man. You are lacking men that have been helped by God to help you. It is men you are lacking. Aika salia marasco. But after tonight, the men that are getting ready. Ilama sakia kata, the spirit of just men that have been made perfect. There is getting ready to be a cloud of witness that will put a demand that you'll be blessed. Put a demand that you come out of that misery and pain. Put a demand that you come out of that singlehood and enter into settlement and marriage. We'll put a demand and insist until thy breakthrough is released. Tonight, we release such men to your direction. 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 It is men that hang Haman, not a spirit. It is an anointing, a spirit that influenced men, that hand Haman on his own gallows. Aila, lekotes kapatale. It still took a man called Nebuchadnezzar. Mephibosheth. Is there anyone in the house of Saul that I can show favor to? Is there anyone in someone's house tonight? And God is willing to begin to tamper with the pain of your loss, pain of divorce, pain of remarrying. Is there anyone in that remainder of that your house that God is getting ready to show favor? You are one of them. You are one of them. You are about to be a different kind of them. I prophesy. God is about to send. He's about to send at the house of bread. He's about to send at the house of Ziba. You're about to be called. A table is going to be laid in the presence of many witnesses. Aikaso, take with everything. Find a way to believe what I'm talking to you tonight about. Find a way. Jot it in thy spirit. Record it in your spirit. Akadabadagaza degede saika pataskuma. Kininini nande gebresku paratuski akai. Kedebe shamananga dantalia kaina manasko. Kitata sakia kaimano. Lika brandoske bregadeli. Magada segedege bresku prakatatalia. Ki presko poronte keme kantalia kaina nanamanda. Kedebe shamana gabranduzia kaite lemenosa. Brunde keski paratoska pai. Kida dadada bantolo kobrokotoska pratalia. In the name of Jesus. Hear me and hear me strong tonight. I'd like you to pray this prayer. He says, men may bring. Notice that men may bring. Not men should bring. Not men shall bring. No, not men could bring. He said that men may bring is a point of courteous endeavor that has come as a result of your gates being open. It's as a result of your doors not getting shut day in and day out. It is a port of entry that ports never get shut day in and out. So that a vessel can come from the deeper waters, from a different foreign country, and bring unto that nation a level and a dimension of goods and an upgrade of life. It is like your life is a port, and that your life will not be closed day in and out like a port of call, that a ship that is carrying the Gentile, carrying the wealth of the nation, carrying the goodies. It is they that do deeper business in deeper waters, that see the wonders of God. I am speaking to you prophetically, parabolically, and many things happening now, but I know your spirit is sensitive. Like you to open up your mouth and tell the Lord, I am a man under authority. Say that, I am a man under authority. Where man is generic with respect to men and women. Yes, I am a man under authority. I decree and declare tonight in the name of Jesus. As I begin to pray, I decree and declare. I conform to the word that has been spoken tonight. I yield my members, my spirit, my soul, my mind and my body. And I decree and declare in the name of Jesus that the force of the Gentiles and that the force of the Gentiles will come in the hands of men. Men from everywhere, from the east, from the west, from the south, from the north. Come now, appear now, appear now, appear now. By the force of favor. Akata, steady motion. Raise you up with a prayer. And as we worship you, somebody's praying.
Aila marazune ke manaski mene mana. Kadarabasofra katalakia bananane. By the force of the Gentiles. Ah, give me the ministry of men. Let me be a beneficiary of the wonders of favor. Bring men unto my labors. Shorten, O God, the days of my labors by adequately sending help out of Zion. By the ministry of men, let favor show up in the face of a man. Aya hasoka patatale. Kide zamia mananda. Weaken me, O God, weaken me. And I may be able to behold what it is that you sent for me in the name of Jesus. That men may bring, that men may bring, that men may bring. For every labor there must be a reward. He said the heavens of the heavens are his, but the earth he has given to the sons of men. Sir, the dimension you want, someone is sitting on that dimension. Someone owns that dimension. The earth has been given to the sons of men. Favor will grant you access to the ministry of men adequately so that you shall be helped, adequately helped, well helped by God, like King Asa, who was helped by God. I say, Shaya Mano Seke Kabaskupa Katatalia. The Bible declared that David was a man, dejected, alone out there. And then killed Goliath, and he ran somehow into the backyard of the desert. The Bible declared that there were men that banded together. The band of David, ragged men that were given to the rules of engagement. They knew what it is that David was carrying. The Bible declared, and they were added unto David. They were added unto David until they became a great host as of heaven. Until they became a great host. In the Bible, Paul says it this way, and help was added. Men were added to help David. They will be added into your life. They will be added unto your life. They will be added unto your life. How about getting into a shopping mall and you get an attendant from the gate to the shopping mall, to the shopping basket, and they move your trolley and they take it to the car and they park for you. All you need to do is to drive off. How does that experience feel? That is a small, minute way of what it is to have a helper that has been put there by the force of favor. It is what the last day church is getting mantled by. Yes, governments will not be able to comprehend what it is and why is it that they favor churches so much, and men and women of God and Christians so much. Political parties will register people. Men will come to your village, to your house, to your office, and beg of you to lead them. They said the band of men that were rugged and raw, that were added to David daily until they became a host of heaven. Pray, whatever you are. I am an anoske, pray, the ministry of men. Favor will bring men. Favor will not bring money, no. Favor will bring men with money. Favor will not open access to business, no. Favor will open access to men with business. Ananamasa kabratolia. Amandeketes kebregada. Kaitetes sididibi ila kabratusa. Lamantes imako. Open up your mouth and tell them, put on demand while the music plays.
start to concentrate and do something. Do some business in the kingdom of God in your house. Something tangible is getting ready to be received by someone here. Elemeno saika paskuparadale. Erebo shayana nana. Kamanando seke pretes kaparadalia. Kiatata sete kabratole. Mandes kabarado. Kaikata skepere tuskabai. Kabadante lekebregedoshka. Mandos kepregedeli. Kabarantos kepregedilia. Famamandos kebegento. Makos kepregedelia. Shagada kabratus kepregedelia. Kipantos kemenanda. Manga de Delia Gaiba Dasko. Scripture declared that men banded themselves unto David in their own life. And they say these were men that were sent unto David to turn the kingdom from Saul unto David according to the word of God. They never had that word. It is David that knew the word of God upon his life together with Samuel. But these were men that were sent unto David to turn the kingdom. To turn the business, to turn the possibility, when all hosts are against you, when all odds are against you, when all the business odds are against you, there is a man that will be sent. Say, man, yes, so now that I can be able to show him favor, to show him favor. To show him favor, they say there is Mephibosheth, but he's lame on his legs. He sends Ziba, go bring him, go get him, bring him to this table. That is the favor and the wonder of favor. When they wanted to take the kingdom out of David's hands, all they needed to do was Absalom to get himself together with a band of men, and he added the counsel that was in David's side called Ahithophel. He was a man. He added to himself a band of a counsel of a man that was called Ahithophel, a man that was moved by the Spirit of God to speak heavy words and deep things. David had to cancel his anointing because he knew if a man that is called Ahithophel is with my son, then the kingdom is done. I am out of that seat. I will be killed. I'll become a fugitive in my own kingdom. So he opened up his mouth and said, let the words of Ahithophel be turned into foolishness. The ministry of men. There are certain things men can bring. Angande samakato kebregada. Agabababusha kabarasko prokototole. Ikamanande gebredos kebregada dalia. Katata kabrado. Don't get tired. Don't get distracted. This is a praying ministry. Yes, this is a praying ministry. He said, Paul declared, oh, I will that men will lift up their holy hands with no wrath. Praying everywhere. Naika so kabratale. Shainama na koskebede. Kabadandalia kai kebedo sama. Maindini bizande gebrezuzia kaipa. Kabadantolia kai telekemelo. Mi kabraduze gebredeli. Sadadaba zagaban katatale. Kirini biato gebredelia kaina manando. They came to David at the cave of Adullam. They followed him to the desert. They followed. Why? The force and the wonder of favor. It don't matter what address you live in. It don't matter what it is that your name is. It don't matter where your business is. It's not about direction or address. There is a God that can command men to come to the desert. Ema kaskupa katatale. Pandele kesku patatalia, shaika pantalia, kaina mananamanda, bengedede, gamaso koprokoto, katua kai, kamasko kototoli, shaikedete, zamande kabratus kapai, ikamanano kamando, baikata is God will only mantle someone with a favor, with favor tonight, as with a mantle, favor as in a shield. No man can lay their hands on you and go scot-free. No man can just pass you by and pass your business name by. Aina Salika Brado. Now that everything is online, now that registrations are online, there is a force of favor that can land on your business name. That will bring in business name up, and they will call you out of nowhere. There is a God of an expected call. There is a God of a, there is an anointing. There is a favor for an expected miracle. Comes as a result of favor. Aisaba. Magada Radanada. Banakataska Prakatoske Prakada. Aikata Kaikamanoske Prakada. Shadadada Bande Kabregado. Magadagadagadagadaga Bregadagada. Shagadagadaga Bregadagada. Yakatoske Prakatatalia Kaikaba. It is Saul, King Saul. He neglected the ministry of a man called Samuel. He ignored Samuel with his anointing. He ignored Samuel. He ignored a man. Figured I can do this sacrifice by myself. You is late. Your anointing could be too small. Your office notwithstanding. Saul, in a penchant for spite, in a penchant for dishonor, in a penchant for going adversely against the word of the Lord. Ignored Samuel, given unto him to sustain his kingdom. The Bible declared, in 1 Chronicles 10, and Saul died because of his transgressions, which he committed against the Lord, even against the word of the Lord, which he kept not, and asking counsel from one familiar spirit that he, we should not inquire, and inquire not of the Lord. Therefore, the Lord slew him. It is God that killed King Saul, because he ignored the dimension of man. And he turned the kingdom to David, his servant. The David to David, the son of Jesse. He turned the kingdom, and that kingdom came with men. It is that kind of favor that came upon David. I speak unto you tonight in the name of Jesus, and men will bring to them not empty hands. We decree the blessing of elevation of the things above, of the things beneath the earth. We speak the blessing of elevation that was given unto you. We bring unto you the blessing of Jacob that was landed on Joseph. You are a fruitful bough, even a fruitful bough by a well. I prophesy in the name of Jesus, whose branches will run over every city. You run over every city, run over every village, run over every country, that the anxious have sorely grieved him, shot at him before, hated on you before. But I produce unto you the force of favor, that by a strong hand, by the mighty God of Jacob, to that end, the God of our Father, I decree and declare in the name of Jesus, even by the God of our Father, you shall go and you shall receive help. You shall go out tonight and help will be with thee. Even by the God of our Father, who shall help thee? And by the Almighty, I now stretch my hands unto you, and I decree and declare, he shall bless thee with the blessing of heaven above, of the things in heaven, the blessing of the deep, the blessing of heaven, the blessing of heaven, the blessing that lieth underneath the earth, in the name of Jesus, the blessing of the breast. In other words, you shall be cushioned and you shall be nursed. Isaiah 6, he said, you shall milk the breasts of the Gentiles. The blessing of the womb, that you shall bring forth and brought forth on due time, like in the days of Eliza, that in the time of life you shall produce results. The blessing of thy father shall prevail above the blessing of thy progenitors. I speak unto each and every one of you tonight, that unto the utmost bound there shall be everlasting bounty that shall come upon all of you tonight in the name of Jesus. Even unto the everlasting heels, they shall be upon the head of Joseph. Favor that went with Joseph. We call upon the same anointing over each and every one of you tonight. Take something tangible tonight out of this service, that you will sleep up a slave tonight, wake up a king tomorrow. It shall be upon him that was separated from his mama's womb. I have ordained thee to be a, come to be a prophet upon the nations. Said, I called thee from thy mama's womb. Psalm 139, he said, I know thy name. All the days that are fashioned for thee were written in thy book. Yet when they were none of them, marvelous are your works. For your name is great. Hallelujah. If you have to go off, come back, but be praying. I like you while you're giving, be praying. Whether by tongues, whether by understanding. Hear me and hear me strong as a prophet. Something strange by the anointing has come into your life that will mark the entirety of your year this year. Oh yes, these two Wednesdays have been crazy in the spirit. God is up to something. He's in a mood to bring unto an end. To bring unto an end a season and open another. While you're on it, type whatever it is that you're typing. Or get into the platform and infrastructure. Get a seed, get an offering. Depending on how God has blessed you, sacrifice whatever it is that you want to sacrifice. Lay it at the altar. For those of you who have already sent your sacrifice by the anointing or by reason of revelation, bless you indeed, of the things in heaven, of the things above, and of the things beneath the earth. Get out an offering, sacrifice, lay it at the altar, speak to it, tell the Lord this is not a Bible study. Somehow seems like we are in a revival. My God, as I said this, I decree and declare, I deploy to this vessel, I deploy, give an assignment to your seed. Give an assignment. Give an assignment to your seed. Give an assignment. Give an assignment to your offering. Give it an assignment. Makoseke benedoshai. Kamana dekeskupatali. Makadoshe benegede kabradalia. Langa bradoske pregatatelia. Konadabaradoske pregatalia kai. About an hour ago, the Lord gave me an instruction to get a part of the tithing and send it to someone that became clear in my ear regarding what it is that I need to do in regards to their schooling. I went to the account, cleared it, sent it to them. They say they were on their knees praying for me tonight for this service. They have no words whatsoever. You know why? Because I am planted in a place where I cannot have a harvest except by the force of favor. They can't pay back, but they are waiting on now because yeah, that God has given them a man under instruction. We reign in this kingdom by mysteries. We reign in this kingdom by secrets. We reign in this kingdom by obedience. It is better than sacrifice. It's better than this sacrifice. Lalo seke bredeli. Makaskabaradolia kaina lakamana no zabai. Kabagadanke dentelia kaina makantoli. Ibibibia barazuzaga via gai kai 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 kai. Kidia kapaskuba dantalia kaina mananomunda. Azuni kimando skobrogodo. Masidia kaina mananamosha. Once and again, many times we've cleared the account. Even the ministry account, personal accounts, and dish out money to people in the family and outside, in ministries. And God has not just only been faithful, He's blown our minds, I and the facility. Haila Masubra Kateli. We don't only preach this thing about theory and become about as talkers only. No, we practice covenant. We see God that has been able to save to the animals. Narakadaga bagandege begesko bragado. Kabadaduza gebregadeske bregatatalia kaita lakabarasko bragatatali. Well, that anointing is moving. I don't know about you. I am not here to fundraise. But hear me and hear me strong, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you, the kind of door that God is getting ready to open
will open there by the kind of sacrifice you become and the kind of sacrifice you release. Akaski parakai, andia kai kadene begadoska prekatatale. Story is told, Mandi Azina Namanda, of me and the first lady when we were about to get married, and you had me share this story. Oh yeah, we sacrificed. Not only in prayer, we labored. Not only in prayer and fasting, we labored. Not only in the word and putting ourselves under the you would say the regimen of the word of God and to be taught about marriage. No, we entered into the place of sacrifice. And even I, personally, without her knowing, we're in the place of the crucible of sacrifice at that time. We're doing everything to send every other coin into a ministry that builds up marriages. Aila salika barasko propototoli kaita tapande maizi zivia kaila mana takes a place sometimes of building up an altar. Oh yes, oh yes, force of favor. Anana kaske predelia kaina mandoza. Oh, come when your heart is searching. Come when your soul is thirsty. Draw near and drink of the mercy, Jesus Christ, at the river of life. It flows from the land of eternal life. There's no more sorrow and no more night. To the hearts that are lifted to Him. When I was young, I was given unto God. I was given as a sacrifice to serve God. Yes, it was not just by baptism. It was not just by immersion. It was not just by word. No, I was dedicated unto God. Given to Him as a Nazarite. Given unto Him as a God, as a servant. My parents have harvested the results of serving God. Long life has been their portion. In the midst of many things that we've gone through, many things that they have gone through, God has been the sustainer. God has vowed with His jealousy that they will not die prematurely without harvesting what it is that they have put in the ground, in the seed of men. Can go over and over and give you mighty, many, many, many mighty testimonies. I will tell you like my apostle will say, I am myself in my reality, a product of many, many anointings. I went there by sacrifice, not empty. I went there even when I didn't have anything. I knelt on the pavement, knelt on the road, stood up on the road and knelt on someone to lay hands on me to say something. Because I saw something in their life. I went there by seed. I went there by sacrifice. And many other times I would get money from my fiance then. And she wouldn't know where that money would go. I will go and plant it someplace. You want to walk into what people are walking in? You want to walk in a dimension of authority? And to force a door open? Sir, it's not by clanging only. Not by clapping hands and clapping and taking a tambourine. It's not by that only. It's taking steps. Sometimes it's painful. Sometimes you will lie down and the door will be closed on you. And sometimes, yes, men that carry something are hard men. Hard to please. But you'll bend low because you're too big for that door. Lalise bratuska makai kairamana. I am a product of several anointings. Tangible ones, sir. Tangible ones. Not theory. No, sir. Men have laid hands on me. Men of stature. Men, if I begin to tell you, you will be wondering, really? How come? Yes, sir. Yes, I've had impartations everywhere. I carry something that is ancient than my own age. Because I went there not only in honor. I have a list of ministries I sent
seems to, I get broke, quote unquote. Somebody can leave their account because the Lord, like today, He says, send it, all of it. I was setting up this meeting. Cleared all of it. This is someone that cannot pay me back. They can't. It's my instructions. I'm not saying this to try to conjure you or put up something or to fundraise. No, sir. I'm showing you mysteries of the kingdom. Where there's no more sorrow and no night. Favor is a person. It's not a thing. Favor is a person. There are many keys to opening favor. One of them is honor. The ability to mark the difference, to know the weight of difference between personalities, hierarchies, protocols, systems of the kingdom. There is a man, I have told this testimony to someone else before. There's a man who was with John Kilpatrick, a man who was with Kenneth Hagin, a man that was under the anointing of Howard Brown when the Brownsville Assembly, rather, what was happening out there in the U.S. A man that has seen God tangibly in the manifestation of revival back in the days. Came to a conference I had no business to do with that conference. I was dropping my daddy and my mama because it was a pastor's conference. I ain't a pastor. I was not called to one, so I was not fitting there. But I hung around that zone that particular afternoon as if set up by the Spirit to receive something. And I'm a very, very, very sensitive personality in my nature. And so that has been jacked up by the anointing and by the office that I carry. I sat in that conference in the afternoon. A man, no portfolio. A man with no office. A man not known by anybody. And I sat there. Here comes a man that was introduced with a name for a child that is called Convergence up there in the U.S. And he began to minister. Nothing really to show for from whatever it is that you would call a very powerful one. It was just cool, calm, collected, and begin to teach and began to say, I was with John Kilpatrick when this was happening, when the revival that lasted, I don't know how many years, over 10 years, in one place where literal angels would be seen in a service, where music will come out, and it's not a priest in playing, it's not a band playing, noise. A blue chair will sit in a service. Thick blue glory will sit in the Brownsville Assembly, and John Kilpatrick will not be able to move. Men will be plastered on a wall. People will be carried on wheelchairs, and immediately they step in that compound, they walk on their own. Men like Yonggi Cho were connected to this revival, and John Kilpatrick, being an offspring of that revival, began to see God, and the heavens opened. All of that Brownsville River is a phenomenon that you can Google on the net. And he began to save out. And I said, God, this is what I've been asking for. This is what I've been looking for. I've been watching Kennedy Hagin, the contemporary of many people and men of God, and been raised up with his tapes and teachings and books from my daddy's ministry. And I was yearning for that dimension. Yearning for that dimension. And here comes a man that was there. Sir, that was the end of my trip back home. I waited for that man, for that conference, and I was there like a hungry man looking for something. I didn't come to play, didn't look for that. Pastors were queuing for food. Man, he finished, he left off, went to the backyard, took some tea in the green room. No man of God followed him. And there were pastors back, including my parents. Mom and dad got off, went to another thing. I was there as a pen of a ready writer, getting ready to get something. No man, and there are about 300 or 400 or 500 close to 1,000 pastors. No single man had what I had. I don't know if this is for whoever it is that the hand of God is coming strongly on right now. The person I'm talking to is sweating. Literally, there is an impartation that is landing on that someone now. I won't mention the gender. But there is a strong anointing on someone right now. Get yourself a seat or a wall or hold on to something. Lisekia paso ma ante ki patolia. Lerebe koshai ina mazadi. Niga bazos kapai. The gentleman came off the pulpit. Went to the greenhouse, took a little bit of something, and came to go to the ministers. He's a missionary place, an American place, so they have a missionary center. I waylaid him. I went straight to the pavement, knelt before he would come close. I told him, sir, I know John Kilpatrick. I know Kenneth Hagin. I know these are prophets. I have a calling for the prophetic. It is not showing yet, not the way I want to. You're carrying something generational that was impacted on you. I want that. I knelt on the concrete while everyone is watching, eating. He laid his hands there, shaking under the anointing. I don't know if it is his nature, but what I felt was a sensation. Came off from his hand, and that was it. I took off, got into the car. I don't know how much I had. I think it was about 3,000 shillings. Got into a Western Union, got an exchange, got dollars, came back, found him, gave it to him. I didn't care how much it was in regards to that level, because at that level I was in that dimension. But I got something worse that I could not pay for. Notice the impartation came while I didn't have the dollar in my hand. So we don't get it twisted. It was my initiation. Notice what I read to you. That men may bring, not men shall. Men may bring. It depends on what it is that you will do. This is a hard gospel many don't want to know. But these are secrets. And that is just one of them. We can dwell here all night. Many things, even the first lady, some of those things she's never heard. There are several she knows. There are some I have never shared. I've not been released. My apostle would always say, before you know a man, check out his story. Get to hear his story. Something tangible is going to come on your life. If you know how the mystery, which key unlocks which mystery. If you will know which key opens which mystery, sir. In this kingdom we reign by understanding. No guesswork. This kingdom. I am a product of many anointings, including Apostle Johnson Salman. Yes, including him. That's why you see, you hear me keep on quoting him. It's because I carry that oil too. Makazibi ina can tell you. You're about to witness something strong. We don't have to wait until we meet. It's not up until the tent has come up, until there is a massive cleanse. No, sir. You take while it is raw in this part of heaven. You take that anointing while it's still moving. I have many things to say to you. We will come to that in another time. Come to the river of life, you will find healing here. Come to the river of life, come and drink freely here. Come when your heart is searching, oh,
Eglah, City of God, City of God. So come with your wounded son, for there is a river. There is a river. Aya, Sikita Ikamano. Amen and amen. Father, we thank you for tonight. You have done us well. You have done us good. In the name of Jesus. We come to the end of this service in an extraordinary way. I sure hope you've been blessed tonight. I'd like you to open up your mouth and just thank him. There's an anointing as we approach Sunday that is coming very heavy. We thank God for every healing that is happening. There's a very thick anointing that's just doing its own thing there. It's got nothing to do with me. Nothing to do with me. So open up your mouth, angel, Angela, give the Lord glory. Everyone, everywhere, wherever you are, open up your mouth and just begin to give him glory. Your peace. Your peace you give me. The storm, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, you are the source of my strength. You are the strength of my life. I want you to hang in there.
You're about to come into harvest. even as we get into the 28th, you are about to get into harvest few days from now, about 14 of you now. Your peace you give me, Shamana Kantolia Kaida, Kerenebo Kabratali Kamande, Baba Baba Sobe Kemekeneskai, Kerenebe Kamando Kabratoli, Mande Kesketa Tetia. You are about to enter into harvest now. There's a very strong anointing to deal with chest complications, vascular conditions, chest issues, including COVID. Made whole now. No more in the name of Jesus. Favor is about to land on someone's address. But in the next 14 days, you're about to enter into the month of March with tangible results. Tangible results. You are strength of my life. Oh my, oh my, oh my. I leave my head total. Thyroid, be cast out now. I just heard it. Thyroid, be cast out now. Anyone with thyroid, in the name of Jesus, be made whole. That affliction leaves you now under this anointing. Yes, I see in the realm of the spirit that the force that has been holding on to your promise never getting fulfilled. People by and large, Sabbatic. Yes, the thing that I'm about to come to you, anything that has been on you as a mark of rejection, there is a vein that is getting torn. A fire is coming upon you, and there is a different girdle that has been put on you. It is a coat of many colors upon you, Eric. In the name of Jesus, the sign will be, I just saw you in a barber's shop. I don't know what it is that you're planning to do, but you will testify and tell us by evidence what it is that you've been planning in terms of your hair. But I see in the realm of the spirit you in a barber shop cutting your dreadlocks. The spirit of the Lord is telling me that is your sign. I don't know, you know. You know that that is what you have planned to do. I see by the realm of the spirit, by the Holy Ghost, by the spirit of God, by the spirit of grace, by the spirit of grace, it will not last 2 months. It will not last 60 days. God is about to release everything that has been behind that gate. He has broken the gate of iron in sunder, and the brass gates have been turned over. Stand the captivity, even as there is one in the days of Midian. The Lord shall do a quick work. He shall do a quick work. He shall cut it short in righteousness. No more delay, Eric. Aina nama seketeti ai. Aina nama shaya mama. Hey, kabababababa talamano. Ninini kasobra talia. Mandelege brazuzi ya kaita samakanto. Makumpante lekezadi ya kaida lama. Total praise in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, it is done. The call shall come. Wait on it. Be expectant like a bride, which knoweth not which hour. Oh yes, the husbandman is getting ready to come. Receive favor, O God. Mantle us to tonight is favor like never before. In the name of Jesus, that men may know the difference between they that serve the Lord and they that serve him not. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Siri di andelega presusa kapakai kia manala. Andelega zadia kai parasko porodole. Sadadaba soko protole. It is not in vain. It is not in vain. Some of you are going to be witnesses in the coming days of what God is getting ready to establish it within your life and even in the context of your family. That it is not in vain to serve God. It's not that it will put a mark of difference. Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Let's sign out. Jesus' mighty name. Alado se que veres tu pratele.
Everybody, we'll see you in the name of Jesus. Bye bye. Good night. Good night. Jesus' mighty name.